Goalies traditionally over the last few years have spent so much time working on their technique, and a lot of times have forgotten that they play 60 minutes of the game inside their head. And so that's the key feature of learning to play a good mental game, is that really, you are on the ice for 60 minutes, but you're also in your head for 60 minutes. And understanding how that impacts the flow of the game and is impacted by the flow of the game. And so understanding that there's a pre-game preparation, an in-game execution, and then a post-game analysis a lot of times. So breaking it down, you're looking at the pregame, you want to spend as much time as you can doing things like visualization. And you know, visualization is a word that gets thrown around. And I don't know if people understand really the base technique of it. And really, what you're after when you're visualizing is understanding what works best for you. And so really finding the visualization technique that works for you. And one of the best ways of doing that is to see yourself playing a successful game, playing a game that you have played in the past, and reviewing that game, but not just reviewing the game from a checklist, but seeing yourself make the saves, getting the sound of the crowd, getting the feel of the sweat on your forehead, basically recreating the game in your mind. You'll see a lot of sports psychologists will talk to goalies about using key trigger words at that time. So while they're replaying those key saves, they're reminding themselves about certain things. For example, if a goalie has a habit of sinking into the net, he'll remind himself big. He'll use a trigger word like big. And in a game where he's had success, where he sees himself big in the net, if you keep refreshing that word big all the time, suddenly as you're about to step on the ice for the next game, if you just review those words, you know, big, as you're standing playing the national anthem or stepping onto the ice, that triggers a lot of positive feelings and brings back a lot of that successful feeling that you had from the night before. So that's the pre-game aspect of it. The in-game part of it is doing things that make you feel comfortable in the net. You know, there are long stretches sometimes where you're just standing there. And so keeping your focus is a huge thing. So if you can understand that, you know, while the play is on, you're following the play rather than looking at the popcorn in the girl's hand on the fourth row, you understand that, you know, following the play. For example, one trick that I've used with my guys is as soon as the referee blows the whistle and the linesman puts the puck into his hand to drop her face off, you zoom in on the puck, regardless of what end the puck is in, zoom in on that puck in the linesman's hand, and now you're back in the play again, even though you've had that moment of relaxation during whistles. As just an example, the other thing you'll see, I had somebody say to me one time, why do goalies get thirsty every time they get scored on? Where they pop their mask off and they take a drink. Well, what a lot of goalies do there is they'll replay the goal in their mind, but they'll see themselves making the save. So there's another trick that you can use when during the game to get yourself out of a negative mindset where you've just given up a goal. So now you review the goal, you see yourself making the save, you take that drink, you pop that mask back down, and you're ready to go. The puck's in the linesman or the referee's hand, you zoom in on that puck, and now you've eliminated that negative aspect. And then you, as far as the post-game stuff, you'll see a lot of goalies will do a evaluation of themselves after the game, where they'll rate themselves from a 1 to 3, for example. You know, a 1 being poor, a 3 being great, you know, or vice versa. And so there's a way of really, after the fact, reevaluating the game, looking at videotape, looking at those kinds of things so that you can improve on your next outing.